So in previous videos, we saw a few examples of how to use for loops in Python. For example, if you have A being equal to a list with three elements, apple, banana, and republic, you can print each element with four elements in A, colon, four spaces, print element. And when you run this cell, you should see apple, banana, and republic, and you do. So another way of doing the same thing is by using the indexes or the indices of these three elements. You can do that with for I for index in range of 0, 3, because this way range will go from 0 to 3, but not including 3, so that would be 0, 1, and 2. And actually, a shorthand for this would be range of just 3, and it does exactly the same thing. So let's see how that works with print I. And you can see that 0, 1, and 2 as expected. So using this as the index, you can just write print A square brackets I, and then it's going to print apple, banana, and republic. And instead of using 3, we could also use len parentheses A, which will return the length of A, which is 3. So this is going to do the same thing as what we had before. So why would we want to use the second method instead of the first method? The way I think about it is by default, you should use the first method, which is like four element in A, because that's a much simpler method. But in some cases, the index matters, not just the element. For example, if you wanted to print apple once, banana twice, and republic three times, here's what you can do. For I in range of len of A, which is the same as what we had before, and then within this for loop, create a new for loop with for j in range of I plus one. And this way, when I is equal to 0, j will be just 0. And when I is equal to 1, j will be 0 and then 1. And when I is equal to 2, j will be 0, 1, and then 2. So actually, the value of j doesn't really matter because we're not going to use it. But the important thing here is that we're going to go through this inner for loop, which includes j once when I is equal to 0. And we're going to go through this loop twice when I is equal to 1. And we're going to go through that loop three times when I is equal to 2. So within this for loop, within the outer for loop, we can print A square brackets I, and that should print apple once, banana twice, and republic three times. Let's run this cell, and that's exactly what we see. Okay, let's now quickly go through the two problems I gave you in the last two videos. In tutorial 5, I gave you this problem. Can you compute the sum of all multiples of 3 and 5 that are less than 100? So that would be the sum of 3, 5, 6, and so on. And then 15, which is a multiple of both 3 and 5, 18, 20, and so on. And here's my solution. First, initialize a variable, let's say total, to 0. And then run a for loop for I in range of 1, 100. So that would be all the positive integers that are less than 100. And in this for loop, just write if I mod 3 is equal to 0. So if I is a multiple of 3, then add this number to total with total plus equals I. And else if, if that number is a multiple of 5, then add this number to total. After this for loop, just print the results, which is total, and we get 2318. So that's the answer. But instead of using elif, we could also do if I percent 3 is equal to 0, or if this number is a multiple of 5, which is the same thing as I mod 5 is equal to 0, then add I to the total number and then print total. So this OR statement says we want to do the following, which is total plus equals I if the first condition or the second condition is true. And if both of those conditions are true, then we still want to do the following. And that's good because when I is equal to 15, we still go through and we still add I, which is 15, to total. And then once we run the cell, we get the same answer, 2318. And here's the problem I gave you in tutorial 6. We were given this list, and the assumption there was that we don't necessarily know the content or the length of this list, but we know that it's sorted in a descending order so that the largest number comes first, and then when you go right, the numbers always stay the same or go down. And we also assume that there's at least one positive number in this list, and we wanted to find the sum of only the negative numbers here. To do this, here's my solution. Let's first initialize total 2 to be 0, and then I'll initialize an index, let's call it j, to the length of given lists minus 1. So that would be the index that corresponds to the last element of this list. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to change j so that we can iterate over only the negative numbers starting from the right, because just in case there are a lot of positive numbers in this list but only a few negative numbers, we don't really want to go through the whole list if we can avoid it. So we're going to do that with while given list square brackets j is less than 0. So while the current element that we're examining is less than 0, add that item to total 2. So total 2 plus equals given list square brackets j, and then go to the next item by decreasing j by 1. So you could write j equals j minus 1, but it's the same thing as j minus equals 1. And after that, just print total 2. So the answer is minus 17. Let's check that. Minus 2 plus minus 3 plus minus 5, that's minus 10. Plus minus 7, that's minus 17. So it looks like this solution is correct. Okay, if you're following these tutorials in real time, you might have noticed that the pace of me posting these tutorials has been kind of slow recently, and it's just because I've been working on other videos. So if you don't want to wait for the next tutorial, I'd recommend the following two courses I have on lynda.com and Pluralsight, and you'll be able to take them for free. So the one on lynda.com is called Get Ready for Your Coding Interview. It is about coding interviews, but I cover a lot of basics in Python, so it should be a good course for you to take after this course. Actually, my voice doesn't sound great in this course, but it's just because I didn't know what I was doing back then, but the content should be good. And the second course I'd recommend is called Introduction to Data Visualization with Python on Pluralsight. And this one's good if you're interested in getting into data analysis with Python. And like I say, you can take these courses for free with their 30-day free trial and 10-day free trial. I'm going to put the links in the description below for these courses, but don't worry because I'm going to come up with more YouTube tutorials too. Okay, again, I'm so sorry if you've been disappointed with the pace of me posting these tutorials, but hopefully I'll see you guys soon in the next video.